you much, Scott. It's great to be here for the 21st Annual Congressional Clean Energy Expo and Policy Forum. It's always an honor to follow the Senator from Maryland, but it's better to be ahead. So let me report, Rhode Island already has a wind farm, North Block Island, in operation. So let's go ahead. And we hope Maryland gets there too. Let me also recognize the Carol Werner and the member of the court for their great leadership and support.
Here, please.
This is an opportunity to get together all these great advocates as well as technologists to talk about what we have to do to keep moving forward with respect to energy efficiency in the United States. For 21 years, you've been doing it, and we've made some progress. We've seen developments. We've seen the issues evolve so that we're using more renewables. We are using tax credits to help sustain this effort. We're driving down costs. We're providing for clean energy alternatives. That's incredibly important. We're looking at new advances in storage, which could be a key to even wider applications. All of that is a result of your efforts. 21 years ago, it didn't look this encouraging, but we can't stop now. We have to keep going forward. More research and development. As I mentioned, my home state, we're very proud. We have our energy farm operating off of Block Island. But we've also understood that this is not just about something aesthetic. This is really about jobs. 15,000 people in Rhode Island have jobs related to this sector alone. And if you multiply that across the country, that is a significant increase. And that's the future. Those are the jobs of the future, and we've got to make sure they're available for the next generation of working Americans. And that's part of what we're doing here. It takes effort at every level, the state level, as Maryland and Rhode Island are showing, but also the federal level. And I happen to be privileged to be the co-chair of the Senate Renewable Energy and Energy Efficiency Caucus with Mike Grapo of Idaho. It's bipartisan, almost bi-coastal. Idaho is almost on the other coast. And it represents the fact that we can get together and think collectively about the future and make a contribution to that future. Now, we need to keep the Department of Energy well-funded, and as Chris pointed out, we rejected some of the calls for draconian cuts. We've just passed a budget that supports continued enhancement of energy efficiency throughout the United States. We've looked at things like weatherization, which is important. We've looked at sustained support for research and development at the federal level, and also coordinating energy storage efforts. These are all essential efforts. And as was pointed out before, as the ranking Democrat, ranking member of the Senate Armed Services Committee, energy efficiency is a national security priority. This goes to the basic level of protecting our force in the field. Why should we be dragging, towing, trucking tons of gasoline to our troops when we can support them with alternative energy? It's dangerous to them and it impairs our mission. We can do better. The Department of Defense has set a goal of 25% renewable energy by 2025. Let's make that not 2025, but earlier. Let's make that more than 25%. It's for our national security and for men and women who serve. We owe them that much. So let's keep that. So let me continue. You are doing incredibly important work. Without your voice, without your advice, without your counsel, we couldn't do what we do. So please keep it up. This is about the future of our environment, the future of our economy and our jobs, and the future of our security. Thank you very, very much.